Thank you, Dr. Naveen sir, and I am very obliged to give my topic on this from RSACP West Bengal branch. And today's my topic is on groundbreaking advances in gadgets in anesthesia practice. So there is first slide of disclaimer in my topic. This presentation is for medical information and knowledge. It specifies that it helps in medical practice, and the use of these innovative and newer gadget informations are subject to individual preference. Further, users are advised to seek professional medical assistant if they want to use. Now, I have classified these gadgets in 5 categories. There are pre-operative gadgets, anesthesia-related gadgets, operation theater-related gadgets, medical gadgets, and post-operative gadgets. Now, this presentation is more on pictures with short description of innovative gadgets. So, you enjoy this presentation. So first we will go with the very basic vital parameters, blood pressure. We have seen that our blood pressure instrument with multi-para monitors and everything. But you see in these slides, there are finger blood pressure monitor, wrist blood pressure monitor, cuffless blood pressure monitor, then wireless blood pressure monitors are available in the market. This finger blood pressure monitor with measures with only finger, wrist blood pressure monitor measures from the wrist, and this cuffless blood pressure monitor, this Taiwan company FreeScan, here the instrument can be kept on the radial artery and it directly measures the blood pressure. And this wireless blood pressure monitor from iHealth, this will give the results on our smartphone. Believe me, all these smart gadgets are available through the wireless or Wi-Fi or Bluetooth with the smartphone or with the attachment through the audio jack or with the power jack. Then thermometer. See, this Medicina company came with this Thermodoc infrared thermometers, and it is a smartphone attached. We have to attach with the this audio jack, and it gives the result in the smartphone. And these are the devices like the multifunction smartphone infrared thermometers are available in the market. It supports the human body, water, food, and environmental temperature testing. And the Kinsa company came with this smartphone thermometers. And the first one is for the pediatric patient. The beauty is that if the pediatric patients are put on this thermometer, and it shows the smiley over the smartphone. So pediatric patient likes it. And this type of the thermometer, it comes with the attachment with the this smartphone. And this is for the adult. So it tells your temperature, offers real-time guidance on what to do next, tracks fever, symptoms, medications, and diagnosis for you, and sends your health details straight to your doctor and lets you know if fever is cause for concern. Then weighing scale. This is a typical weighing scale. It works by the Wi-Fi core smart scale, and it measures the 9 aspects of your body composition with only medical grade scale. It measures weight, lean mass, body water, bone mass, muscle mass, BMI, body fat, visceral fat rating, and daily calorie intake. So it is a very useful for the all these hospitals. Then we came with this pulse oximeter. We have seen regularly in this COVID pandemic finger pulse oximeter, but this is a ring pulse oximeter. Just like a ring, we have to wear on the finger, and it will shows in the results will be shown in this display. Then wrist pulse oximeter. Again, neonatal patients will be put in neonatal ICU with the neonatal disposable pulse oximeter. That is a wrist pulse oximeter. And this is a wireless pulse oximeter through Bluetooth. I am using this from iHealth since last 7 years, and I'm very happy. When I'm sitting outside my OT, then I can see my iPhone, through this app, my patient's SpO2. And this, again, another attachment from eye oximeter is available from the SafeHeart, where you can attach this probe directly on your smartphone, and it shows the result on this smartphone. Then even all the smartphone having a near field communication, this device, then it pulse oximeter will be, this can be seen by the NFC also, and it is coming in the market very soon. Now disposable probe, SpO2 probe, fluoride sensor probes are also available in market. Even in tongue probes are also available in the weight anesthesia. Then this BioVit company from Israel came with the this wrist type of the watch, and this shows, this measures pulse rate, blood pressure, and SpO2 both. So it is very useful in this all the patients who are on the post-operative period. Then Masimo company came with the oximeter to measure respiratory rate in children and adult. So it measures SpO2 plus respiratory rate from the plethysmograph. And Masimo again came with the oxygen reserve index. It measures the oxygen reserve index but it nicely gives the advance warning of the impending desaturation in these machines. Then people came with the first response monitor. It tracks the heart rate with respiratory rate in multiple trauma patients. It is just a nose clip, like it clips onto the nose and immediately begins the monitoring, and it shows the heart rate plus respiratory rate. Then people came with the smallest size of the, like smartphone size of the handheld pulse oximeter with blood pressure, like PM50 ambulatory, SpO2 with NIBP, and Quantica 08 digital blood pressure monitor with SpO2. People also came with the handheld pulse oximeter with capnograph, like Burton's and Smith Medical. They came with the very small instrument, like again, smartphone size. This attached with this, even in smartphone also, and the smartphones like instruments, and handheld pulse oximeter with capnograph. Then if you are fed up with your regular stethoscope, then these are the smart stethoscopes are available in the world. The first stethoscope is Viascope. This is a smartphone enabled stethoscope approved by FDA. Then this is the smallest powerful thinkling, just plug in and practice. This is the smallest size of the stethoscopes available in the world. Then people came with the Ikoro, where the machines could be put on the patient chest or backside of the chest, and the results will be shown in your iPad or your in smartphone. Then this Cambridge Medical came with the Ecoscope, which shows the integrated electronic stethoscopes and electrocardiogram in the same stethoscope. And Japanese people came with the U-scope. If you are fed up with your routine stethoscopes, then it is a completely redesigned stethoscope for improved ergonomics. It reduces the pressure on the ears and comfortably fit while wearing it. Now, if you go to smartphone ECG machines, then this is a Alive Core Cardia mobile EKG. I am using since last 5 years this EKG, where we can attach two pads on our smartphone backsides, and we can take this from our palm with EKG on our smartphone. Then people came with a smartphone Cardio Defender. It is a world first ECG system which delivers hospital-based quality ECG and arrhythmia analyzed by the integrated unique smart software. And this is MobMon, available in 75,000 rupees. It is a smartphone-based 12-lead ECG machine and with pulse oximeter. Then this is a smart defibrillator. This is Australian company Indiegogo came with this smartphone defibrillator. Here the beauty is that it will go in AED mode as soon as the two pads are pulled out from the backside of the smartphone case. And it immediately immediately dials the country's emergency number, and it gives the, locates the locations, and it gives the instruction to the rescuer. And this is the from Ladel company A4 size defibrillator. And it works on the Bluetooth wireless transmitter module and smallest and textbook size. It works on the presenting VF, and it determines the initial therapy, whether we should give shock first or CPR first. And these are the implantable defibrillators, which are the even the heart attacks or cardiac arrest is there, then it gives the defibrillation from the inside the body. Then this is rescue CPR system, where two parts are there. Rescue pump and rescue POD. The rescue pump delivers optimal chest compression on every shot, and rescue POD used by another person delivers proper amount of air to oxygenate. And this is a Crick spice. If there is bad things, then if the patients are arrested during intubation or extubation, then cricothyroidectomy, it speeds up the process and leaves less room for the error to speed up the cricothyroidectomy. It then breaks up to reveal the port through which an endotracheal tube is inserted. The beauty part is that it is a very simple instrument to use, and no need, it will be finished within 1 minute also. And these are the smart glucometers. Now again, smartphone is used as this glucometer, glucose monitoring system. It works wirelessly with smartphone. Again, this iHealth company came with this. And these are the attachments are available in the market from Amazon. It are hardly cost 500 to 600 rupees. And this is a glucose-wise, this is non-invasive blood glucose concentration to be measured at the capillary level. The glucose levels are extracted by a non-invasive technique. It utilizes two unique technologies, high-frequency radio waves and integrated nano composite film. Here, no need to penetrate the skin by lancet. And this is a diario glucometer. Diario is a warm-colored gadget which includes much more than a regular glucometer, a lancing device to provoking a small blood flow, and it connects to your smartphone. Believe me, all these gadgets, what I am showing you, they works either through the smartphone, either through your any gadgets or or via software or via Bluetooth or via Wi-Fi. And this is a sugar beet. It is a pain-free, non-invasive. It is a continuously monitoring and small disposable patch painlessly stuck on the user's arms, leg, or abdomen. It measures the body's glucose level via the skin connected to a small electronics sensor and results shown in the watch like a smartphone, smart wristwatch. There is a, even not from the blood, we can measure the sugar from the blood. We can measure the sugar even from the our tears also. So people came with the NovioSense. It is like the flexible ocular insert for glucose monitoring. It is a small and flexible spring-like device, 2 centimeter in length and 1.5 millimeter in diameter. Device measures minute changes in the glucose level in the tears that are representative of blood glucose level, uses wireless data. And the Google and with Novartis company came with the smart contact lens glucose monitoring. It measures continuous glucose levels in the tears by nanotechnology. And it is very useful in our anesthetized patients. And these are the smart spirometers. These smart spirometers, we can attach these all these types of the these instruments on the, our smartphone directly with the audio jack or this power jack. And it flawlessly connects to your smartphone so that you can easily see and share the result to the test. And this is the non-invasive hemoglobin measurement that is from Orsens. Non-invasive blood analytes monitor. It works on occlusion spectroscopy. It measures blood hemoglobin, pulse oximeter, and pulse rate. And Masimo came with the RAID 57. It measures the oxygen saturation, pulse rate, perfusion influx, and plate variability index. And if it is upgraded with Pronto pulse oximeter, then it measures the all sets of hemoglobin measurement like this total hemoglobin, methemoglobin, carboxyhemoglobin, and total arterial oxygen content. And then Netanyahu-based company from Israel, TytoCare, came with this for pre-anesthetic checkup and telemedicine. And this small instrument, which is very palm-sized instrument, and this device includes regular stethoscope, thermometer, otoscope, built-in camera, and tongue depressor. So it is very useful for the PAC and telemedicines. Then people came with the vital patch. It is a banded-like disposable vital signs monitor. And shows result on a smartphone. It measures single ECG, heart rate, PR interval, respiratory rate, skin temperature, body posture, fall detection, and activity, including steps. So it is very useful in the ICU setups where, and the results will be shown in our smartphone or in the computer. Even our sweat will also measure the biochemistry and glucose level. So people came with the sweat sensor also. Then smart vein finders. Routinely, we are using whatever the smart vein finders. If we are fed up, then Google came with the Google Glasses, and even the ultrasonography guided this wearable infrared glasses for venipunctures are also available. Then there is a small instrument that is a TAP, at home blood collection system. It is very tiny, around 3 centimeter of size. It nearly painlessly collects the blood. The single use device features micro needles that penetrate the skin without the causing significant pain. And if you are giving injection intramuscularly to hemophilia patients or something like bleeding disorders patient, then self-sealing needles for preventing blood loss after injection. It is a biodegradable polymer coating that can plug an injection site called Chitosan. And there is again valinovascular new needle free blood flow device available. It's a new version of its needle free blood draw device. The product is connected to a peripheral IV catheter and allows drawing the blood straight into syringe or attached vacuum tube. Patients already on a peripheral IV don't have to undergo traditional venipuncture. It's a very good innovation. Then there is a smart vein flowns. Delta vein closed system came with the peripheral IV catheter. It reduces the risk of the exposure to the patients. It contains the two ports with chamber and the lock system. It is available in wide range of gauze from 16 to 26. And this IV cannula with integrated three-way is available in the market. So no need to go for extra three-way stopcock. Then safety IV cannula with injection valves are available. When you insert a vein flown, then your needle goes straight away into this safety chamber. And this type of vein flowns, when the needle comes out, and the needle tips are covered by the umbrella. So there is a safety needle in a vein flown. And Dr. Mahurkar, he is from Indian origin. He came with the Mahurkar smart syringe. And there is no possible reuse The needle holder is locked to the plunger. After use, the entire syringe is interlocked. So needle will go directly in the plunger after injecting in the muscles. Then there is a smart adhesive bandage, 8-tack. They are waterproof bandages, come with the anticoagulant, antibiotic, antifungal, and wart remover. It releases a multi-compound therapeutic substance onto the sterile pad. Then this is the anti-snore devices for the post-operative period. Patient for chin-up, from Dupuyako company, chin-up type of this snore devices came. Patient airway support device used for the MAC and TEWA sedation procedure. And in our even again post-operative period, if the patient is having very sedated, then anti-snore chin support straps belt are available on Amazon. It is hardly of 230 rupees. And this type of the smallest CPAP available in the world, that is a airing from airing. And they have got a inhalation port and exhalation port. And there is a housing. And the people came with the snore free nose clips. It gently opens the nostril to increase airflow. And built-in magnet provides magnetic therapy. And it is a non-invasive. It is also around 200 to 300 rupees. Then in my gastroscopy practice, I have developed this type of the endoscope. I have seen this type of the endoscopy, mouth guard and mask. This is a Ovescepian fiber optic intubating airway. This is a VBM endoscope mask. This will be attached directly to our trolley, and the scope, the gastroscope or fiber optic scope go through this. Then this is OxyGuard, oxygenating mouth guard. It is a unique oxygen nasal port. Here the oxygen porties are different and we can give oxygen through this port. Easy and safe to use. It delivers oxygen to both the mouth and nose. It saves time, efforts, improves patient comfort, and it is a disposable. Then Spanish mouth guard for ERCP anesthesia. There are two ports, one port for the oxygen and a second port for the capnography. So this is a very good instrument for in the ERCP patients or with the prone position endoscopy for. And these are the endoscopy supraglottic airway devices are available. This is a LMA gastro airway. Where one port is for the gastroscope and one port is for our tube connections, that is for our trolley. And this is again a laryngeal tube, that is also two connector, gastro-laryngeal tube, one for the scope and one for the endoscopy lumen. Then different nasal and endotracheal tubes are also available. Nasoflow company came with the Nasoflow and nasopharyngeal airway device. It allows for direct oxygen delivery. The beauty part is also that they have got an optional respiratory indicator with or without hydrobar. So it can measure even the capnography also. Then Hylard Microcraft subglottic suctioning endotracheal tube. That is, they have a separate channel for this, separate cup for this endotracheal suctioning. Then Endoflex endotracheal tube. No need for the stylet to introduce in this endotracheal tube. The distal part of this endotracheal tube will be flexed or deflexed around according to our laryngoscopy view. Then from Chinese company, one of the Chinese this scientist came with the nasal jet tube or nasal jet endotracheal tube. Both are very good for this and jet ventilation. Then 3M company came with the newly marketed DuraPore advanced surgical tape. The new product enters the skin, various tubes, and to itself when its surface is moist, having different textures in humid environment, the tap is designed to perform well. Up till now, we have seen the hinge type of the laryngoscope. This is the Macintosh switch style laryngoscope. So it is like a screw type. Then Rodinia company came with the Tilke Magels forceps for easier and safer nasotracheal intubation. So here the endotracheal tube will be catch very nicely. And in for pediatric anesthesia, scented anesthesia mask available. It improves the patient's tolerance and reduces the children's pre-surgery anxiety. These are the different scents we can use with this anesthesia mask. Then for pediatric sedation, this Exon sedation mask are available for dentistry and orthopedic surgery. And these are the scented masks designed to optimize the comfort and minimize the anxiety, lightweight and stays out of the way of the nose. There is no prongs. So it directly attach over the nose. And this is there is a unique system to anesthesia outside the operation theater. It is a Sevo. The dragon uses fire breath to distract kids from the getting Sevo for an anesthesia. It is used during the anesthesia induction. But the beauty is that the childs are instructed to see on the TV screen, and he is given a Sevo fluorine mask, and when he is instructed to take deep inhalation or deep exhalation, at the same time that the dragon also exhales and inhales, and the childs are instructed to take the deep breath and deep inhalation or deep exhalation, then there's again this dragon will do that same job. So the child will enjoy and it goes into sleep. And this is a sideline monitor, children's brain under anesthesia from the Masimo. It assists the maintaining the proper depth of the anesthesia to prevent side effects while helping to improve post-surgical unit. These are the video laryngoscope, smart video laryngoscope. I have developed this smartphone video laryngoscope 5 years back, first time in India. It is an industrial boroscope, and I have attached with my smartphone. My smartphone works as a monitor and as well as light source, and very economical and easy to use. Anybody from any part of the world can use this type of the video laryngoscope in the initial period, and we can in 500 rupees, this type of the Android boroscopes are available in the Amazon. And this is the first time laryngoscope with built-in suction. It helps to speed the patient's intubation, particularly benefiting in emergencies. And now the disposable video laryngoscopes are available in the market. And this is Anapanograd. It automatically keeps the endotracheal tube cup pressure at the right pressure, a system that automatically adjusts the pressure of endotracheal tube cups. Then the rapid positioning intubating stylet. The new type of stylets are available. It dynamically intubates the stylet with controlling tube, which can flex and retroflex. From this catch, we can flex and retroflex the endotracheal tube end. And these are the smartphone USC machines are available. This is a latest one, Butterfly IQ multipurpose pocket size ultrasound. I have seen this instrument in my colleagues, and these are the software we can download in the iPhone, and there are attachments are available through the audiophone jack, and we can measure the sonography through this software. And Philips and Haberts also came with this mobile uni scanner, this ultrasonography like smartphone. And this is for the Neuropol echogenic needle from Equic company. Plexus needle with the latest ultrasound reflection technology. It is specifically designed for the ultrasound guided regional anesthesia procedure. Now, if you are alone to give the regional blocks, then this is Saphira system, that is a safer injection for regional anesthesia. The anesthesiologist administers regional blocks, and it allows the anesthesiologist to deliver regional anesthesia without relying on an assistant to actually inject it in the right pressure. And for the PG students, there is a spinal simulator for learning how to place needles for the blocks are available, Asterisk 1.0. The device is essentially a representation from human with transparent tissue so that the bones of the cheek, back, and spines are clearly visible. And these are the epidural space and spinal space locator instruments are available. One is from Equic company. The sound waves means the acoustic puncture assistant device. The penetration of the epidural space is indicated by clear variation of the acoustic signals. Here the signal will decide that how much you are inside the epidural space, and they will safeguard to you. Then this Acuro Rivana company came with the first ultrasound based system designed specifically to help you apply spinal and epidural anesthesia with automated identification of the epidural location and depth. This CompuFlow epidural anesthesia system measures pressure at the needle tip. It able to provide precise and continuous measurement of the pressure at the tip of the syringe, both helping the guide anesthesiologist when assessing the epidural space and recording the procedure for any post-op review. And this Epic from this Polydiagnostic come with the 2.4 millimeter of the disposable epiduroscope. It is the smallest size available in the world. And these are the trolley. Why I put these slides? Because these are the typical trolleys developed by the Britain company Supera. This is oxygen concentrator which are attached with this trolley, and the oxygen, no oxygen bottles are required for this, and it gives the complete trolley with a ventilator, with a vaporizer. And so this anesthesia machine is with oxygen concentrator. And these are the anesthesia depth monitor from the now Fresenius Kabi has taken this instrument. So it's a Qcon and Qnox. Anesthesia, this was the earlier version, and this is the latest version. Then this NOL monitoring, I think Belgian company came with the nociception level monitoring. NOL guided analgesia reduces the risk of excessive use of the or underuse of opioids and associated complication. And this is typical anesthesia workstation with agent management features. It provides live monitoring of the agents in use. helps to reduce the waste and creates a report at the end of the each procedure based on the calculation of agent use. And this, our Anshul company came with the two surgery gloves. That is Gamex PI. The inner gloves is bright red color, bright green color, while the exterior one is the natural skin color. If the exterior glove is damaged by scalping, then for example, the green from the glove below suddenly pops out. It's certainly a nice safety feature for the clinician. And this is the smallest ventilator available in the world. That is only even smaller than the A4 size. The beauty is that it is used from the street to stretchers to in the air, in the OT or in ICU. It supports invasive, non-invasive or transport ventilations. And you can have a pulse oximeter integrated with this ventilator. It is from the BD company. And these are the smart Wi-Fi switches and plugs for the OT gadgets through the artificial intelligence. So you can manage your all the gadgets and OT lights through your smartphone only. And even the hospital light bulbs that disinfects and kills the bacteria. The light targets naturally occurring molecules called porphyrins that exist inside bacteria. The light is absorbed and are excited molecules produce reactive oxygen species inside the cell. And the 405 nanometer emitted from indigo light creates a chemical reaction inside the cells similar to the effect of the bleach. So it disinfects the OT, our OT operation theater and outside operation theater. And these are the digital plaster, a device meant to be embedded in the ordinary plaster that includes sensor for monitoring health related data, such as blood pressure, temperature, and glucose level. And the people came with the Vitti gel hemostatic jet kills. It gel that stops bleeding in seconds. When directly applied to the source of the bleeding, it rapidly adheres to the wound site and stops the flow of the bleeding by creating a mechanical barrier. This allows the body to build a strong natural clot without the need for applied pressure. Then we have seen the syringe infusion pump one or two, but these are the 4-in-1 stand, 6-in-1 stand. And even China company came with the 12 syringe infusion pump in the one stand. And this is a bio-weld one. This is a cold cautery. It's a unique device to seal surgical incision using cold plasma gas. And this is a drug releasing sticky space. This is recently introduced in 2020. It's a novel polymer technology only available just now for the ibuprofen only. And this is the Riba. It developed in the Japan. And this is a robot for interactive body assistance. No need for stretchers or wheels. Riba is the first robot that can be lift up or set down the real human from or to a bed. It is a programmable. If you give them instruction from OT to ward, then the robot will carry the patients from that only. And this is a Stryker wireless hospital bed with smart monitoring features. A new completely wireless hospital bed that spots the number of smart patients monitoring feature. When connected, the bed will stream parameters such as bed configuration, including the position of the side rails, exit alarms, and movement to hospital's information systems so that important events can be noticed and recorded. These are the electronic underwear preventing bed sores. The electrical underpants deliver a small electrical charge every 10 minutes. It activates muscles and increases the circulation in that area and effectively eliminates bed sores, thereby saving lives. And these are the portable CT scan and portable MRI. Somatome, the Siemens Somatome on-site mobile head CT scanner, the device can be easily brought in directly into the patient's room. And thanks to its powered wheel and an onboard battery, the only one person is required to move newly CT scanner from room to room. And this is portable MRI. Portable MRI wheels right to the point of care, plug into the standard three-prong wall wallet. It's operated through a tablets that wirelessly connected to the MRI machines. Hyperfin company. And these are the MRI compatible IV infusion from M-Radium 3860 Plus. It is the world's only non-magnetic IV infusion pump. It is safe to use around MRI machines up to 3.0 Tesla. The device can pump dose from 0.1 to 1400 ml per hour. And this is A-Lung Hemolung Respiratory Dialysis System. Hemolung respiratory assist system that removes the carbon dioxide from the blood, letting the lung rest without having to undergo ventilation. It saves the patient from sedation, intubations, ventilator, and associated pneumonia and other complications. Believe me, I have collected all these gadgets. I have more than 500 gadgets on my computer, but specifically for this topic, I have selected these 150 gadgets. And for this all works through the smartphone or by artificial intelligence, by Wi-Fi or by Bluetooth. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for a very captivating and extremely interesting list of gadgets. I mean, we are absolutely stunned by the list. I would request the chair to take up the questions in the chat box and
thank you, Dr. Kasturi. Heartiest congratulations, Dr. Tushar, for she is very rightly pointed out a galaxy of newer gadgets in all the practices, whether it is a BP monitoring or to as advanced as a bedside ventilator. Well, there are a lot of questions from Avnish, so I'll straightway invite him rather than typing him. Avnish, you can ask your questions to Dr. Tushar directly. Also unmute yourself and please go ahead.
Good evening, sir. Thank you so much for giving this opportunity. Good evening to all the faculty and colleagues. Tushar, sir, this was a really great talk, and I was feeling like Alice in Wonderland for the whole talk. And I think you can write a complete book on this, especially for the upcoming anesthetists.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
Yes, I would like to tell you, I'm also interested in artificial intelligence and machine learning. Okay. So I just have some questions like, is there any regulatory framework presently which is trying to regulate the licensing of these gadgets, because they can be used by anyone, even non-anesthetists?
Just now, there is no licensing authority, not even India, not in outside India. So some instruments are FDA approved. I have not written that, but more than 30% gadgets are FDA approved. Something like that, this stethoscope with this ECG and this integrated EKG, they are Cardia mobile EKG on smartphone, then Indiegogo, this defibrillator, they are all FDA approved. So some are FDA approved and some are for the laymen's or for the doctors or even for the paramedical workers.
Okay, sir, one more question, last question, that suppose we use such a gadget and it results in a medical error or failure, then who is responsible for the error? Is it, even if the device is FDA approved, will the company be responsible, or we are responsible for that?
But the doctor, how many cities for even the FDA approved gadgets, even your anesthesia workstation also, even in the multi-para monitor also, anybody can litigate on any instruments, even whether it is FDA approved or even it is not FDA approved. So, I don't think there is a litigation. Litigations will be every. So that's why I put a first, let's say, disclaimer. Okay? If we want to use this, all these instruments, and then seek the professional colleagues' help or the company who is making.
I understand, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, Naveen, sir. Thank you.
Dr. Tushar, can you please put on your video, please? Okay,
thank you. Thank you, sir.
Somebody has asked a question, and Dr. Shashikala has asked a question. What is the cost of mobile ultrasound, and it is available? Is it available in India? And no, I add on to it, use of mobile ultrasound with PCP and NDT restrictions in India.
In India, it is not allowed. But when my friend came from this US, and he has shown to me, he's a radiologist, and when came from the New Jersey, and in his iPhone, he has shown me the software of Butterfly IQ, but he has not brought this probe also, but I have seen only this software. And he was telling that it is available in, I think, in Indian rupees, 2.5 lakh rupees of the software. And you have to take the separate probe for that. That is a 3.5 hertz something.
So as of now, it is not available in India.
It is not available, and it is not even
licensed to use.
Licensed to carry.
Right. Dr. Lalit Regar is asking about the cost of transparent spinal stimulator.
No, sir, I don't have an idea.
No, any idea. Okay. Okay. Others are complimenting you. And last question from Dr. Arun is, Conox is for anesthesia monitoring or analgesia monitoring?
Right. Deep anesthesia monitor. Anesthesia depth monitor. It is a.
Yeah,
right. Yeah, it is anesthesia depth. See, it is now taken by the Fresenius KB. And in India, more than 500 machines are now in use. And in South India, Kerala, in one medical college, they are using more than 10 Conox machines. So it is an anesthesia. And in Tiva, now it is a fashion for to use Conox monitor in Tiva practice.
Right. I'll invite my co-chairperson, Dr. Ashok Kumar, sir, to say a few words. Dr. Shukumar, sir. Sir, please unmute yourself.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, to have a nice interaction with all of you. And Dr. Tusar has presented a very good thing for everybody and a large number of gadgets. And I think everybody will be...
You are not audible, sir. This.
Not audible?
Slightly loud, hello? Just slightly loud. Be loud.
Ah, yeah. Yeah. Good evening, everybody. And Dr. Tusar has presented a very nice discussion regarding gadgets. And many of the gadgets, everybody is not acquainted with that. And I think this will produce an impetus to newer persons, newer anesthesiologist for this. Thank you. I think
thank you,
this is a nice one. Bye.
So thank you, Dr. Tushar. With this, we hand it over to the for a nice talk and back to you, Dr. Kasturi.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. So we move on to the third talk of the session. We are very pleased to welcome Dr. Devanjali Ray, who will be enlightening us on the topic, namely novel gadgets for management of difficult airway. Well, in its broadest sense, as we already know, the difficult airway has been defined as challenges associated with any four methods of oxygenation. Either it is face mask ventilation, supraglottic airway ventilation, endotracheal intubation, or front of neck access. And most of them are actually challenges, anatomical challenges of difficult airway. There is, of course, an entity of a physiological difficult airway, and there are various new gadgets and devices and techniques to overcome this crisis. So I am sure Dr. Devanjali will throw more light on it. And it's a privilege and great honor to welcome Dr. Gurjeet Khurana and Dr. Shravani Basu to kindly chair the session. Madam Gurjeet Khurana is presently a professor and in the Himalayan Institute of Medical Sciences, Uttarakhand, and she holds special interest in the intensive care medicine and trauma care. She has many international and national presentations and publications to her credit, and she is the president of Central Zone of Uttarakhand State Chapter of ISA. Welcome both, madam. Dr. Shravani Basu is in charge and head of the Department of Anesthesiology and Surgical ICU of B.R. Singh Railway Hospital, Kolkata. And madam has been the immediate past president of ISA Metro City, Kolkata, past scientific secretary of ISA West Bengal branch, and is an active member of the IDA Kolkata branch. We welcome you, madam. So we request the chairpersons to kindly introduce the speaker, Dr. Devanjali Ray.
Dr. Devanjali Ray, he is at present the Assistant Professor, MPMMCH, Tata Memorial Center, Varanasi. She, in addition to her Master's in Anesthesiology, she is also a Fellow of Interventional Pain Management. She has many publications to her credit. She is the winner of the Basudev Guha Memorial Best Paper Competition of